Thank you, Paul. It is called the Cyber Professional League. What the heck is it?
Gadget guy Dave Mathews joins us now to tell us what the heck it is. Dave, the CPL.
Well,
what is this exactly?
Angel Munoz started this company, or this group, in 1997 to make computer sports just like legitimate sports. Now, legitimate sports, what is that anymore? Is that, do you have to have fans? Does it need to be Olympic caliber? You know, obviously football is a sport, but is golf a sport?
Yeah.
There are many people who argue that it is.
Right.
My husband is one of the people who argues that it's not.
Is figure skating a sport?
That's right. So all these questions. So Angel is trying to make computer gaming a sport because you need great hand-eye coordination, you sweat. Some of these guys have even made mice and controllers that have fans inside of them to keep your hands cool.
Oh, my gosh.
But the World Series of this event is taking place right now. They're going to announce the winners today. It's in Dallas. And 1,400 kids showed up, and I shot some video of this event because it's amazing what they had there. If you look around the room, there are just computers everywhere. These kids brought their whole PCs down.
These are computers from home.
From home.
And
they brought 20-inch monitors, which weigh maybe 100 pounds. They've totally tricked these computers out. They have more horsepower than computers most businesses have. Some of these machines are even liquid-cooled. And here's the game that they're playing. They're playing Half-Life Counter-Strike. And there are 125 identical computers set up that they play during the competition. And you can imagine the networking that they had to do to connect all these things together. But here's an example of some neon in the computer. Now, in the 50s, you'd soup up your car, right? You'd have a hot rod. And even in my era, we had the lowrider trucks that we'd soup up. Well, these guys, they souped up their computers. This one even has a tachometer on it. They have all sorts of lights, gauges, flames on
now
the side.
Now, that's just silly.
Isn't that neat? Now, my favorite, and this one's made out of magnesium. My favorite case was a guy from, he lives in the UK now, Johan Grunstrom, and he took a 1950s radio, turned it into the computer. This one I haven't figured out. It's got a lotion dispenser, a Kleenex, and a coin-operated slot. So that's how you power that up.
These guys really take this seriously. I mean, for us, we're getting a chuckle, but for them, this is serious business.
It's a serious business. And this is a case modding competition where the half the competition is playing the game, the other half is how cool of a computer case do you have. This one's a takeoff from the movie Alien, where he actually used fiberglass to make this alien-esque case. Now, here's my favorite. This is a 1940s radio. It used to have 5 transistors inside of it. Now it has an Intel processor, so it has 28 million transistors.
Oh my gosh.
So that's a big upgrade. This guy, he's a LAN administrator, flew over from overseas with this, so this was his carry-on luggage, and you can imagine.
Oh, security. Security. Tank with that thing.
And this is great. This is an immersive display. It's 3 LCD panels that immerse you visually inside the game. So as you look left and right, you can see all around the game. And then geeks have to dance too. Well, I didn't know this, but there's a game, DDR, Dance Dance Revolution, and it's like a bad Texas line dance. These guys, it hooks up to the PlayStation. Now, this is phenomenally successful in Japan. And there's 86 locations at video games where you can play this in the U.S., but you can download, or you can buy this game for the PlayStation. There's even a Britney Spears version. But the best is these guys are playing Japanese versions. They have to modify their PlayStation, and then they dance on these pads, and these kids get into it. That's the controller, so you don't use a joystick. And when I asked them, I said, now, when you guys go out to bars, do you take these things?
Take
these, no, not the game, but do you take the same moves with you? And they said, bars?
What's the bar?
What's the bar?
What's that? Prom? Never heard of it?
That's right. But it's an amazing event, and it started, there were 200 spectators in 97, 300 maybe some odd people. Now it's 1,400 kids showing up to play games.
What ages? What's the age range, would you say?
I'm kind of embarrassed to say, but some of my 30-year-old friends were there.
Dave, what's up?
I'm like, no way.
Did you dance with them?
I wanted to, but I was a little afraid.
Well, the money invested. I mean, it's so much cheaper if your kid takes up soccer. It's amazing.
And these kids paid $50 for this event, but the prizes, $150,000 to the winner. So
And there's one ultimate winner, or there's a category?
They play in teams, and you'll see some of these guys have headsets on. And what they do at home to practice, they use the internet to play with each other, and that's why they have the headset, so they could speak to each other on the same team. And to keep these guys going, they were drinking this new drink called Balls, B-A-W-L-S. And it's got 3 cups of coffee worth of caffeine in it. And this is what was really keeping these guys up at late at night. So
I
wanted you guys to partake and feel
That's
what it's like.
What I need is caffeine.
So there you guys go. You get the ball. You're going to need to have these stickers, because when you start buzzing around...